I just really have had such an awe for this state.
Every artist is inspired by something.
Every part of Colorado could be a national park.
For Julie Lydell, it's the Colorado outdoors.
A lot of my artwork really focuses on the landscapes themselves.
Beautiful paintings inspired by her trips across the state.
I drive quite a bit. I drive to probably about 15 different Colorado art shows a year.
But it was on her way back from a show in Breckenridge when Julie's life changed in the blink of an eye.
Unfortunately for me, I was the only car on the road. And out of the inky blackness, I come up over the crest, and there is a wall of elk.
Lydell would somehow walk away from this crash, her windshield smashed and her Nissan totaled.
Your heart sinks because the connection to living up here in the mountains with these beautiful animals, the last thing anybody wants to do is have an accident with them.
Accidents that are becoming more common, with an average of 4,000 collisions reported every year, costing Colorado drivers an estimated $12 million in repairs. One problem spot, this stretch in Douglas County, known for its beauty and abundance of wildlife.
And I-25 goes right through the middle of it.
Katie Doyle has to respond to those crashes and says they often are not pretty.
You have to imagine what impact that had, not just for the elk, but the family that hit it.
Finding solutions to get large animals from one side to the other has been tough. That is, until now.
This is where the magic happens.
Five new wildlife underpasses are now complete in the gap south of Denver, along with 28 miles of new fencing and escape ramps to funnel animals away from traffic. In September, zero deer collisions were reported in this stretch.
Super exciting. I really hope that's more the rule than the exception.
Brandon Moret's team has been monitoring the progress with dozens of cameras at each crossing. These cameras have already captured all sorts of wildlife, from deer to elk, even bear.
Bears, mountain lions, coyotes, raccoons, anything you can really think of.
And I think that's the ultimate example of wildlife saying that this is a success because they feel so comfortable.
Moret is especially happy to see elk using the crossings, an animal historically nervous of tight spaces.
This one is now 100 feet wide by about 14 feet high. It makes it very easy for deer, elk, whatever species to move east and west of I-25.
The goal is to reduce collisions here by 90%, potentially saving drivers millions of dollars each year.
I can't hit anymore and still be insured.
Julie Lydell is back behind the wheel and admits she thinks about the crash often.
Driving is a part of life and it is dangerous, and we just got to get back behind the wheel and get up and do it again.
She's hoping the state can add more crossings in years to come, protecting drivers and the animals that call Colorado home.
So when we really adapt to what their patterns are and say, okay, we want to try to help in that way, our impact can be huge.
In Douglas County, Evan Kruegel, FOX 31.
Yeah, definitely.